You know, one thing the anime industry is better than the rest is that there's almost no large gaps between releases, especially when you do a weekly show like I do. By the time you'll be finished with one season, the next one either finished itself or might as well be finished, so there's never any shortage of content, unlike, let's say, cartoon or video games industry. It does wear you down on occasion, but, well, that's what interseasonals are for. A way for me to relax and talk about something else. Arte is a 12-episode historical job anime created by Studio 7 Arcs that tells us a story about Arte, a lower noble girl who wants to become an artist in 16th century Florence, and that's pretty much it, really. We follow her on her way to become a master artisan, even though it is a predominantly man's job and everyone tells her to go back to kitchen, while she meets various people who either like her or tell her that she's a woman at her places in the kitchen or be a dick warmer to some rich noble. The word feminist anime was often used when my employers talked or described this show, and though I can most certainly see why, don't let it fool or scare you away, because this is, quite frankly, fairly typical for this sort of genre, not to mention that fish-out-of-water cliché is fairly common in anime in general. The most basic way for me to describe the story of Arte would be me saying slice of life and profession anime. It is a show about a girl who just does her daily job while a lot of words is told about why things are the way they are. Arte is a character is basically a girl that likes or wants to do boy stuff, her art tutor is a cold, gruff old man, there's a bratty girl, blah blah blah, kinda like with the previous anime, your enjoyment of it will depend on your enjoyment of the character interactions as a whole. Well, and maybe if you like Italian culture, anachronisms and Japanese elements notwithstanding. I'm not going to say it's a bad anime, quite the opposite, really. Arte is a character is pretty pleasant and fun to watch, she's hardworking, not really obnoxious, and is really passionate about what she does. The supporting cast is fun in its own right, and most importantly, shippable with Arte, which means that the usual brood of fans will have something to talk about. The music is smooth and helps lulling you into watching. The graphics are, well, they are nicer in action, but on screenshots you can see the cut corners and overall cheapness of the production. The historical setting is fairly well made, at least as good as it can get without going into details. So to summarize, Arte is not unpleasant to watch. It is a well-crafted, light-hearted story about a girl who follows her dreams and lives a happy life as a result. Kinda like Hakumei and Mikochi, and just like Hakumei and Mikochi, it will be quickly forgotten compared to the heavy hitters of the season, leaving it to be that nice little anime people occasionally remember but never quite wanting to rewatch without a reason. Still, if you want to watch something wholesome and optimistic, then this anime is made for you. If you don't? Well, then think about it in this way. It is a show where men have a set of hard standards to adhere to, women who wish to work in their environment have to do more work just for their co-workers to not scoff at them, both are ultimately objectified as their labor is the only thing that matters, while the union dedicated to protect workers' rights not only allows, but enforces this. There is probably some sort of commentary in that whole sentence, but it's merely an anime, so why should you care?